think about core fixed income investing, you often want to focus on duration, yield curve management, and industry selection. We'd like to set that all off to the side for high yield and focus on security selection. We believe that we can generate competitive returns by looking at the quality of an issuer's underlying business. Now, quality and high yield don't often go hand in hand because clearly we're not talking about balance sheet quality. All of the issuers in the high yield market have had something happen on the liability side of the balance sheet, whether it was a merger, that they used debt to finance, they could have done something shareholder friendly, or quite frankly, they could have been a leveraged buyout. So there's lots of reasons that companies come to the high yield market. But what we ask our analysts to do on a daily basis is to go in and focus on the abilities of these companies to generate stable and predictable free cash flow. And we use that as part of our hallmark formula for investing in the high yield market. First and foremost, we don't think that the rating agencies do a great job in the high yield market. Quite frankly, they have a lot of issuers that they have to look at. And because of the volume of issuers that they do look at, they tend to focus on one thing. And we believe that thing to just be leverage. We think that there is so much more to focus on in the high yield market. And if you just focus on leverage, you're going to take yourself in the wrong direction. We think that you should instead focus on predictability and stability of free cash flow. And so we ask our analysts to do deep dives on all of the credits that they evaluate. And we are quite willing to go and play what we call triple C by design. These are usually leveraged buyouts of companies in very stable and predictable industries. Think packaging, healthcare, food, or media. What we do like to avoid are what we call triple C by accident credits. These are companies that have gotten themselves into trouble for a wide variety of reasons. It could be something simple as an acquisition that has gone wrong, or potentially there are companies that are exposed to commodities, and they inevitably always have too much debt on their balance sheets at the time that the commodity cycle turns against them. We continue to be constructive on the high yield market for three main reasons. First and foremost, we continue to believe that the US economy is fine. Slow and steady growth is going to allow our issuers to perform in line with expectations, generate cash, and service their debts. Second, we've been very vocal in our belief that corporate credit quality in the high yield market is exceptionally strong. Companies have taken advantage of record low interest rates to term out maturities and lower their interest expense. In fact, the majority of issuance in our market has been for refinancing, not for mergers and acquisitions or LBO activity. So if you get concerned that we're getting a little too long in the credit cycle, we believe that because corporate credit quality is so strong, that our issuers are going to be able to hang on and do just fine for the near term. Finally, but a little less compelling, are valuations. We've had an incredible run of spread tightening from north of 900 basis points back in February down to closer to medians, so think around 550 basis points. So while we still think because of the US economy being okay and corporate credit quality being good, there still is room for spread tightening, but not to the dramatic extent that we've seen year to date. However, versus other fixed income classes, we do think that there should be room for high yield in your portfolio.